Hey, I'm Nikki. Welcome to Again Faster. Today we're talking jump ropes. If you have a brand new rope, the first thing you're gonna wanna do before you practice your double unders is size it appropriately. So, one end in each hand, step on it with your feet, don't fall over, and then pull that rope right to chest level, kind of right underneath your armpits. So this rope right here would be too long for me because it comes all the way up to my shoulders. So I would get one end to a comfortable spot, mark on the other side where an even spot is, probably a little bit lower than that even. And then I would move the end of my screw so that the handle is stopped directly in that spot. And here's the most important part. I would practice with the rope a few times before I end up cutting the cord and making it so I can't make it longer ever again. So make sure that that rope is at an appropriate size before you end up trimming the end. Once you have it sized appropriately, you're gonna wanna figure out the best way to store it for you to make sure that it lasts as long as possible. So many of our ropes come with these handy dandy storage bags. It's the best way to make sure that your rope doesn't get tangled in your gym bag with whatever else you have in there. To coil it up to get into that bag, just follow the cord's natural curve, kind of like you're wrapping an electrical wire. It should be pretty easy to figure out where it's most comfortably coiled. If you end up storing your rope at the gym, try to find a place where you can hang it evenly over at least two points, rounded points. What happens sometimes when people hang it, let's say, over one point, like a nail in the wall or a screw in the wall, or over a hard edge, is it ends up making a crease in the rope. And when that happens, your rope can fray. You definitely want it to last as long as possible and stay intact. If you have any other questions about this or anything else we have here at Again Faster, remember, you can always reach out to us.